we're going to take a look at making the circular pattern thing here on 5.5AA. We'll be using construction lines, points, constraints, sharing the sketch, trim, revolve, hole, circular pattern, extrusion. Here's what we're going to be making, here's what it looks like when it's done. Here is the profile that we're going to revolve. Let's take a look at starting to make that. It looks like it is 0.375 off of that light construction line right there. See that? Try and zoom in. And then it is one wide, 2.5 tall, and finish the rest off. So, create sketch. I'm going to go ahead and do a construction line. I'm going to do it right off the origin. Turn off construction line. And our shape, let me take a look at it again. Just the basic owl. I'm going to kind of cheat and use my hints for my constraints to make sure everything I do is constrained to begin with. Dimension from here is 0.375. Smaller for now, just to make my sketch look small. So, as long as they collapse like that, you can redimensional and move them, so that's about what I want it to look like. One across the bottom, one off of the center line. Let's take a look at that. Dimension here to there is one. And construction line to top is 2.5. Width is 0.5. So I guessed earlier that was 0.5 and I was right. I did delete it to get it back where I wanted it. And now I'm going to make it official. That is 0.5. And that'll stay right there like that. Okay, that was fully constrained. Go ahead and I'm going to do a 360 revolve around the construction line. Finish that sketch. Revolve that profile. That axis, full 360. And let's get a look at it from there. I'm actually going to right click on, oops, sorry. I'm going to click on that left face. I'm going to right click and rename that current view as front. And then right click here, current view as home fit to view. Now that kind of reset up my, my views there. I kind of like that it looks a little better. next thing it asks us to do is to place a hole. It says it right here. Sketch a point that is vertically aligned with the sketch origin and locate an appropriate distance from the part center. Use the hole feature to place a 0.5 through hole at that point. Here's the number they're talking about, 1.65. So I'm going to create a sketch on that surface. Then put point. See the dotted line right off there, and dimension the point to point 1.65. All right, finish sketch, go back to home, and then they want to have a 0.5 dimmer through hole. Hole tool, so automatically select that for us. We want to have a through hole, that's all set up. Then it's going to tell us to use the pattern function. So we're going to use a circular pattern and then array the hole around the center axis. We need to have 10 holes around the part center. So we are going to do right here. Circular pattern. Feature. Axis. We want to have picture looks correct. All I did was choose that circle because it chose the center of it actually to work. So, let's take a look at that back at home. And here. Looks pretty good. Alright, we are going to save that as circular pattern IPT. I want that printed off today in an IP in an IDW with dimensions and a parts list. This should be made out of aluminum 6061. And that is your part. Printed multi-view, aluminum 6061. And printed today and turned in, please. Thank you.